Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ba'd. Welcome to episode 4 of Truly the Believers Have Succeeded. In today's episode, we're going to take a brief look at verse number 3 of Surah Al-Mu'minun, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the believers by saying, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ, and those who turn away and avoid idle speech. Meaning those who truly have belief, who have faith in Iman inside of their hearts, they avoid, they shun, they stay away from any type of useless speech and behavior. They avoid al-laghw, which is defined as every word and action that is useless, without purpose, that's done in vain, and that brings no benefit to the individual. So it includes both things that are verbal as well as things that are physical. So any type of speech that's useless, that's vain and idle, any type of action that has no purpose behind it is classified as al-laghw. And the commentators of the Qur'an, they mention that there's 4 different types of laghw. The first is speaking without thinking. So saying the first thing that comes to our minds, not thinking about the consequences of our words. And that's why it's extremely important for us to recognize the power of our tongues. That this little piece of flesh inside of our mouths, it carries tremendous power. It has the ability to bring us great benefit, to bring us a lot of reward. But at the same time, it's something that can also cause a lot of harm, a lot of hurt, and a lot of pain. We might say something to someone that brings them joy and happiness, so it becomes a source of reward. But at the same time, we could say something that causes a lot of pain and hurt, and it can become a source of punishment. And that's why it's important for us to always weigh our words and to think before we speak and to remember that every single thing we say is being recorded. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, وَمَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ, that a person doesn't utter a single word except that there's a watcher, a raqib, atid, that's ready to record. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam very beautifully told us, مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ, that whoever truly believes in Allah and the last day, then let them say something good or remain silent. The second type of al-laghw is any type of indecent speech. So any type of indecent, immoral speech you can think of is classified as laghw. This includes dirty jokes. This includes immoral speech. It includes cursing and speaking with obscene and foul language. And unfortunately, this is something that's becoming very difficult for us to avoid, especially in the society and culture that we live in. So for example, regardless of what legal opinion you follow regarding the permissibility or the impermissibility of music, I think we can all agree that the vast majority of songs today that are popular would be classified as al-laghw. So for example, if we take the most popular rap songs, the most popular hip-hop albums, or the most popular R&B, pop songs, alternative, whatever it may be, and we actually listen to the lyrics carefully, we'll find that it's full of the utmost immoral things you can think of. They're all talking about drinking and alcohol and drugs and sex and money and materialism. I mean, some really disturbing things that if we read the lyrics, we ourselves would feel ashamed. And it's extremely important to be conscious of what we consume with our ears, because the words that we listen to, they can have a huge impact on our spirituality. They can affect our hearts, they can affect our thoughts, our mind, and especially our behavior. And this is something that the Prophet ﷺ warned us about as well. He told us, "Al-ghina yunbitu an-nifaqa fil qalb kama yunbitu al-ma'u az-zar'a," that singing and songs, they create hypocrisy in the heart, or they cause hypocrisy to grow in the heart, just like water causes plants to grow as well. So to be conscious of what we're consuming with our ears is extremely important. It's important to avoid this type of laghw. The third type of laghw that they discuss is any type of action or behavior that has no purpose behind it. It's useless. It's being done solely for the sake of entertainment. And again, we see that this is a huge part of the culture that we live in, the society that we live in. Entertainment is a huge part of our daily lives. Whether it's TV shows, whether it's movies, whether it's the news, whether it's sports, whatever it may be, we constantly find ourselves with this need to be entertained, this need to occupy our time. And that's why we've developed this concept of I'm just killing time. And it's become very difficult nowadays to take value and to have time management skills because there's so many distractions coming our way. Just think about how much time we spend perhaps watching TV, or how much time we spend watching the NBA playoffs, or how much time we spend online looking at various websites, or on our social media, whether it's Facebook and Twitter and Snapchat, Instagram, whatever it may be. And unfortunately, this little device in our pockets, it makes it even more difficult that we're constantly on our phones wasting time. So it's important for us to recognize that time is one of the most valuable gifts that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to us. And part of taking advantage of time is making sure that we treat it as something invaluable, as something priceless, making sure we have the best time management skills. And that goes into avoiding al-laghw. And the fourth category, the fourth type that they speak about is any type of sin of the tongue. So whether again it's lying, it's backbiting, slander, speaking ill of people behind their backs, all of this is counts as idle, useless, vain speech. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that true believers are those who stay away from all of these things. They completely avoid it, they completely stay away from it. And that's because a true believer doesn't have time for any of this nonsense. Their hearts, their minds are occupied with things that are way more important, that are way more significant. Their hearts are occupied with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're always thinking about Allah's existence, His glory, His might, His majesty. They're thinking about good deeds and reward and punishment. They're thinking about the hereafter. They're thinking about ways to use their time in the most beneficial way possible. And part of that is avoiding and shunning vain, idle talk and behavior, which is al-laghw. Now that doesn't mean that as believers we can't have fun, we can't entertain ourselves. There is a time and place for everything. As a matter of fact, pleasure, enjoyment is a main part of human life as well as part of the human experience. But everything should be done within limits. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us amongst those who are described in this beautiful verse, وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ, who stay away from, avoid and shun useless, idle speech and behavior. جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.